Hi students, welcome to the next session. In previous session, in exercise 7.1, 10 questions over. Now I will start from question number 11. In 11th question, evaluate integral x cube plus 5x square minus 4 by x square dx. Okay, first you divide separately integral x cube by x square, 5x square by x square minus 4 by x square. Now here x square gets cancelled. Here x 3 times, here 2 times, 1 time will get. Now write down the remaining integral. First we have x plus integral, next we have 5, 4 constant, if x square go to numerator x power minus 2 dx. Here power 1, this is x power n formula, x power n plus 1 by n plus 1, k integration kx, so 5 integration 5x minus 4 into x power n plus 1 by n plus 1, that is x power minus 1 by minus 1 plus. Now it can be written as x square by 2 plus 5x minus half minus plus 4. This x power minus 1 can be written as 1 by x plus c. That is answer. Next, 12th, evaluate integral x cube plus 3x plus 4 by root x dx. We divide separately integral x cube by root x is nothing but x power 1 by 2 plus 3x by, same I can take root x, or you can x power 1 by 2, 4 by x power 1 by 2. Now here 3 minus 1 by 2, that is nothing but 5 by 2. This x can be written as root x into root x, 1 root x cancel, 1 more root x is there, x power 1 by 2. Okay, you can write 4 by root x only, because we have formula for 1 by root x, that's why. Now, integration of first one, x power 5 by 2. Next, 3 constant you write outside, x power 1 by 2. 4 constant you write outside, 1 by root x. This is x power n formula, x power n plus 1 by n plus 1, x power 5 by 2 plus 1, that is nothing but 7 by 2 by 5 by 2 plus 1, that is nothing but 7 by 2 plus 3. It is also x power n formula, x power 1 by 2 plus 1 by 1 by 2 plus 1 plus 4 into, what is integration of 1 by root x? 2 root x plus 7. If you simplify, the 7 by 2 go to numerator, 2 by 7, x power 7 by 2. Now here 3 and 3 gets cancelled, this 1 by 2 go to numerator becomes 2, x power 3 by 2, 4 2 just 8, root x plus c. This is the answer for 12th question. Next, 13th question, evaluate integral x cube minus x square plus x minus 1 by x minus 1 dx. In numerator, first two terms you take x square common, next two terms you take 1 common. Again numerator x minus 1 common. What is remaining? X square plus 1 by x minus 1 dx. Both gets cancelled. Now integral x square plus 1 dx. Integral of x square dx plus integral of 1 dx. X square x power n formula. X power n plus 1 by n plus 1 x cube by 3 plus k integration kx 1 integration 1x plus c. Next 14th question. Evaluate integral 1 minus x into root x dx. If you multiply with root x, 1 into root x minus x root x dx. That equals to integral root x can be written as x power 1 by 2. X root x can be written as x power 3 by 2. Again, these both are in the formula of x power n only. X power n plus 1, 1 by 2 plus 1, 3 by 2, by 3 by 2. Next, here n is 3 by 2, 3 by 2 plus 1, that is x power 5 by 2 by 5 by 2 plus. You send 3 by 2 to numerator, 2 by 3, x power 3 by 2. You send 5 by 2 to numerator, 2 by 5, x power 5 by 2 plus c is the answer. Next question. Question number 15. Evaluate integral root x into 3x square plus 2x plus 3 dx. Okay, now integral root x means x power 1 by 2, 3x square plus 2x plus 3 dx. You multiply this 3 terms with x by 2, x power 1 by 2. That is 3, bases are same, power should be added, 2 plus 1 by 2, that is nothing but 5 by 2. Here 2, here power is 1, here power is 1 by 2, 1 plus 1 by 2, 3 by 2. Plus 3 into x power 1 by 2 dx. Now integrate separately by taking constant outside. Now 3 is a constant, remaining x power 5 by 2. Here also 2 is constant, x power 3 by 2. Here also 3 is constant, x power 1 by 2. These 3 are in the form of x power n plus 1 by n plus 1. X power 5 by 2 plus 1, 7 by 2 by 7 by 2 plus 2 into x power 3 by 2 plus 1 5 by 2 by 5 by 2 plus 3 into x power 1 by 2 plus 1 3 by 2 by 3 by 2 plus 6. If you send these values to the numerator, that is 7 by 2 go to numerator, 2 by 3, 2 by 7. Now 6 by 7 plus 4 by 5. Now here 3 and 3 gets cancelled. 1 by 2 go to numerator becomes 2. X power 3 by 2 plus c. That is the answer for question number 15. Next. Question number 16. Evaluate 2x minus 3 cos x plus e power x dx. Integrate each and every term. 2 constant, x dx, x means power is 1, minus 3 constant cos x dx plus e power x dx. That equals to 2 into x power n formula, x power n plus 1 by n plus 1 minus 3, integration of cos x. That's why formulas are very, very important. Sin x, integration of e power x plus c. Now 2, 2 gets cancelled. Now the answer, x square minus 3 sin x plus e power x plus c. That is answer for question number 60. Next, 17th question, I am giving homework. You try this question. Integration of 2x square minus 3 sin x plus 5 root x dx. Okay, so this question is a homework. Same method, you can solve one by one. 2 constant x square integration, 3 constant sin integration, 5 constant, you write root x can be written as x power 1 by 2. Next, 18th, evaluate integral secant x into secant x plus tan x dx. You multiply first secant into secant, secant square plus secant into tan. Both are the direct formulas. Integration of secant square x is, that is nothing but tan x. Integration of secant x tan x, that is nothing but secant x plus c. That is 18th question. Next, 19th question, integral secant square x by cosecant square x dx. See, this can be written as integral 1 by cos square by cosecant square can be written as 1 by sin square. Now the sin square will go to numerator, cos square come to denominator. Then sin square x by cos square x dx. Sin square by cos square is nothing but tan square. But we don't have direct formula for tan square x. That's why tan square x can be written as under root of secant square x minus 1. Now integrate separately. Integration of secant square x tan x, integration of 1 x plus c. Next, question number 20. Evaluate integral 2 minus 3 sin x by cos square x. Okay, first dividing this each and every term with cos square x, that is integral 2 by cos square x minus 3 sin x by cos square x. Okay, integral 2 into 1 by cos square is nothing but secant square minus 3 into, this can be written as 1 by cos into sin by cos. Okay, now 2 constant, I will write outside. The remaining function is secant square x dx. Here also 3 constant, I will write outside. 1 by cos, that is nothing but secant. Sin by cos, that is nothing but tan. Both are the direct formulas. 2 into integration of secant square x, that is nothing but tan x. Integration of secant x into tan x, that is nothing but secant x plus c. Okay, first exercise completed. Next, methods of integration. What are the methods in integration? In this first one, substitution method. Okay. okay.
Second one.
Integration by using partial fractions. Third one, integration by parts. So these are the methods by parts. Okay, first we'll discuss substitution method. Okay, what is meant by substitution method? In this method, so we substitute a variable in place of certain function such that the derivative of the function is present in the expression or problem. That's why that substitution is suitable. Okay, I'll give a simple example. By taking example, you will understood the concept very easily. Evaluate integral of sine of log x by x. See this question, we can't find the value by using the formulas directly. So that's why here sine function is there, log function is there, x function is there. In place of log x function, I can substitute a variable t. You can take any variable, k or whatever it may be. Now, whether check it, this is suitable substitution or not. First, differentiate both sides with respect to x. Log x derivative 1 by x, t derivative dt by dx. Now, 1 by x dx is equal to dt. Whether check it, this value is present in the question or not? Yes, 1 by x dx. Whenever this value is present in the expression, that substitution is suitable. Now the question will be changed to integral sine. In place of log x, substitute t. Then 1 by x dx is nothing but dt. Now see, the entire expression is changed in terms of t. What is sine x integration? Minus cos x. Similarly, sine t integration minus cos t plus c. Don't leave. Again, we need to substitute the value of t. T how much? Log x. That is nothing but minus cos of log x plus c. So, what is the substitution we took that is suitable? Here in place of log x, for example, if you take x is equal to t, for example, differentiate 1 dt by dx. Now dx is equal to dt. So here dx is equal to dt is there. In place of x you can substitute t. Now log x we need to find. That's why this expression will be complicated. That's why if you take log x equals to t, the expression is very simple to integrate. That's why what is a variable you are taking in this expression? that compulsory it should be suitable, then only integral value will be simplified. Okay, now we will discuss few questions based on this method, but one thing important, in exam they never asked use substitution method, use partial fractions method, use bipartite method, and some problems we can solve in more than one methods. That's why don't think it is exercise 7.2 question, I need to apply substitution method. No, what is the idea you are getting in PU, you can apply any of method, no problem in PUC. Now problems, example first one, evaluate integral sine mx dx. See this question we can solve in two methods, either substitution method or direct also we can do. If you do directly, what you will get, main function is sine, sub function is mx, sine integration minus cos, by inner function derivative we are writing in denominator mx, kx derivative k, similarly mx derivative is m plus c. If you apply substitution method for this question, let mx is equal to t, differentiate with respect to x, m into x derivative 1, t derivative dt by dx. You cross multiply, dx is equal to, if m come to this side, 1 by m dt. Substitute this value in the given question, that equals to sine, in place of mx we can take t, in place of dx we can take 1 by m dt, 1 by m is constant, you write outside, integral sin t dt. Okay, now 1 by m into, what is integration of sin x, minus cos plus c. Substitute t value, that equals to minus cos, t is nothing but mx by m plus c, both we got same answer, either you can do directly or you can do by using substitution method. Okay, next question, second question in this examples, evaluate integral 2x into sine of x square plus 1. 80% of the question in this chapter, in this method, what is the value which is present in bracket, that only we are taking t, not for all questions. Okay, here I am taking x square plus 1 is equal to t, differentiate with respect to x, x square derivative 2x dx, I am writing directly, this derivative is dt, actually dt by dx, again dx cross multiply, constant derivative 0. Now this 2x dx is present in the question, therefore it can be changed, integral sine, in place of x square plus 1 you can write t, 2x dx is nothing but dt, sine integration is minus cos plus c, that equals to minus cos, finally substitute t value is what, x square plus 1 plus c, that is the answer for the second one. Next, third one, integral tan power 4 root x secant square root x by root x dx. So here you can substitute, let tan root x is equal to t, this is main function, this is sub function. Okay, directly differentiate with respect to x, main function tan, tan derivative secant square into root x derivative 1 by 2 root x dx is equal to dt. Now simplify, secant square root x by root x dx is equal to, send this to this side, it becomes 2dt. Now check it, this value is present in the question, secant square root x by root x dx. Now it can be changed. Integral, this value is t, so t power 4 you will get. Secant square root x by root x dx is nothing but what? 2dt. Two constant you write outside, t power 4 dt. This is in the form of x power n plus 1 by n plus 1, that is nothing but t power 4 plus 1 by 4 plus 1 plus c. Now 2 by 5, finally substitute t value. T value is how much? Tan root x whole power 5 plus c is a answer for this question. Next, fourth, evaluate integral sine of tan inverse x by 1 plus x square dx. Here also I am taking tan inverse x equals to t. Let tan inverse x equals to t. Differentiate with respect to x. Tan inverse x derivative 1 by 1 plus x square. So in this method we are using differentiation formulas as well as integration formulas. That's why you prepare both formulas perfectly. Tan inverse x derivative 1 by 1 plus x square dx is equal to dt. This value is already present in the question. Now the question is changed to integral sine tan inverse x is nothing but t, 1 by 1 plus x square dx is nothing but dt. Again sine integration minus cos. Finally substitute t value, minus cos of tan inverse x plus c. Next, fifth question and examples. Integral sine cube x into cos square x dx. Okay, now this can be written as sine cube x, I can write sine square into sine into cos square x dx. Again this sine square can be written as 1 minus cos square x, again cos square x, again sin x. Okay, here I am taking cos x is equal to t. Differentiate with respect to x. Cos derivative, not integration, minus sin x dx is equal to dt. If you multiply both sides with minus, now sin x dx is equal to minus dt. This sin x dx is present in this question. You substitute here. Integral 1 minus t square sin x dx is nothing but minus dt. Minus I will write outside. Now minus of 1 into t square into t square, t power 4. If you multiply with minus, these two values will be, places will be interchanged. Now t power 4 dt minus t square dt. X power n formula, x power n plus 1 by n plus 1, that is nothing but t power 5 by 5 minus, it is also x power n formula, t power 3 by 3 plus c. Finally substitute t. T is what? Cos x. That is nothing but cos x whole power 5, or you can write cos power 5x by 5 minus cos x whole cube by 3 plus c. Already I told you need to practice each and every formula 5 times, because without formulas we can't do one step also. Here in this method especially differentiation formulas we are using, as well as integration formulas using. So practice both formulas, each and every formula 5 times. Next question. Integral sin x by sin x plus a dx. In this question, I'm taking x plus a equals to t. Let x plus a equals to t. That implies I can write x is equal to t minus a. Okay, now differentiate with respect to x. X derivative 1 plus constant derivative 0 dx is equal to dt. Now I'll get dx is equal to dt. Substitute this value in this question. Now it can be changed to integral sine. In place of x, we can write t minus a. By denominator, sine x plus a is nothing but t. In place of dx, we can write dt. The entire question is converted in terms of t. We know formula in first PUC, sine of a minus b formula. I am applying this integral sine of a minus b formula, sine a cos b minus cos a sin b by sin t. Now you divide every term with sin t. If you divide this by this, sin t gets cancelled. Now integral cos a dt. If you divide cos by sin, that is nothing but cot t into sin a dt. Here so many students will confuse, cos derivative is sin. See, if you want to integrate, I already told, if the function is in x, we are integrating with respect to x only. So these two variables should be same. But here this is a, this is dt. That's why cos a is not a function. The function is always in the variable x and y, we generally will get. So cos a is a constant. Here also sin a is a constant. Don't write integration of cos is sin a, because here a is there, here t is there. So here cos a is a not a function, cos a can be considered as a constant. So constant we can write outside 1 dt. Here also sin a also constant, you write outside, remaining cot t dt. Now one integration, generally we are taking one integration is x, but here what is variable? T. That's why cos a into one integration, don't take x. Here t is there, that's why you take t minus sin a into, this is formula, integration of cos x log sin x, integration of cot x log sin x plus c. Finally, in place of t, you substitute x plus a. That equals to cos a into x plus a minus sin a into log of sin x plus a plus c. This is the answer. Next, integration of 1 by 1 plus tan x dx. How to evaluate this one? Integration of 1 by 1 plus, it can be written as sin by cos. Okay. Now, because we have direct formula for, and this is also u by u formula, u by u formula also not there. If you write into cos, you take LCM. Cos is LCM, cos go to numerator. Cos x by cos x plus sin x dx. It is also not possible to simplify. That's why I will do one more thing. Divide with 2, multiply with 2. By practicing, you will get idea. because we don't have coefficient rule in integration chapter. Derivative chapter you can use. See 2 cos x. Again, this numerator 2 cos x I can write cos x plus sin x plus cos x minus sin x. Check it here, sin and sin gets cancelled, cos plus cos 2 cos. By denominator cos x plus sin x dx. Now divide separately, 1 by 2 into integral cos plus sin both gets cancelled, 1 remaining here. Don't cancel this. This is cos minus sin. This is cos plus sin. Cos x minus sin x by cos x plus sin x. Okay. This integration we know. How to do this? It is in the form of f dash of x by f of x. Log of mod f of x plus c. What is the meaning of this one? The derivative of denominator which is present in numerator. What is denominator? F. F derivative. F dash. Similarly, you take this. Cos derivative. Minus sin. Sin derivative. Cos. Means the derivative of denominator is present in numerator. You can apply this formula. According to this formula, answer is what? Log mod f of x. That is nothing but 1 by 2 into 1 integration x. It is in the form of f dash x by f of x. According to this formula, we can write log mod f of x is nothing but denominator value. We can write cos x plus sin x plus c. Now we'll start exercise 7.2. Second exercise. The second exercise completely based on the substitution method only. First one. Integral 2x by x square plus 2 dx. This question we can solve in two methods, by taking substitution and as well as f dash x by f of x. Okay, I am explaining substitution method only. I am taking denominator value is 2, t. Differentiate with respect to x. X square derivative 2x plus constant derivative 0 dt. This 2x dx is already present in the question. Therefore, it can be written as integral 1 by this value is nothing but t. 2x dx is nothing but dt. What is formula for integration of 1 by x? Log mod x. So log mod t plus c. Finally substitute t value. Then log mod in place of t, we can substitute x square plus 2 plus c. Or otherwise you can use directly, it is in the form of f dash x by f of x log mod f of x. That also correct. Next, second. Integral log x whole square by x dx. So here I am taking log x is equal to t. Differentiate with respect to x. Log x derivative 1 by x dx is equal to dt. Substitute this value in the given question. Now it is changed to integral. This is t, means t square. 1 by x dx is nothing but what? Dt. It is in the form of x power n. X power n plus 1 by n plus 1. That is nothing but t cube by 3 plus c. Finally substitute t. T is nothing but log x. Then substitute log x whole cube by 3 plus c. Next, थर्ड क्वेश्चन इंटीग्रल 1 बाय एक्स प्लस एक्स लॉग एक्स डीएक्स इन डिनोमिनेटर टेक एक्स कॉमन इफ यू टेक एक्स कॉमन व्हाट इज रिमेनिंग 1 प्लस लॉग एक्स नाउ अगेन विच इज टी 1 प्लस लॉग एक्स इक्वल्स टू टी 1 प्लस लॉग एक्स इक्वल्स टू टी डिफरेंशिएट विथ रेस्पेक्ट टू एक्स वन डेरिवेटिव जीरो लॉग एक्स डेरिवेटिव 1 बाय एक्स डीएक्स इज इक्वल टू डीटी दिस 1 बाय एक्स डीएक्स इज ऑलरेडी प्रेजेंट इन द क्वेश्चन नाउ इट इज चेंज टू इंटीग्रल 1 बाय टी डीटी यू गेट व्हाट इज द फॉर्मूला फॉर इंटीग्रेशन ऑफ 1 बाय एक्स लॉग मॉड एक्स प्लस सी फाइनली इन प्लेस ऑफ टी यू सब्स्टिट्यूट 1 प्लस लॉग एक्स लॉग मॉड 1 प्लस लॉग एक्स प्लस सी नेक्स्ट फोर्थ क्वेश्चन इंटीग्रल साइन एक्स इंटू साइन ऑफ कॉस एक्स डीएक्स सो हियर कॉस एक्स इज इक्वल टू टी डिफरेंशिएट With respect to x, cos derivative is minus sin dx is equal to dt. If you multiply both sides with minus, sin x dx is equal to minus dt. This sin x dx is present in the question. Now the question is changed to integral sin cos x is nothing but t, sin x dx is nothing but minus dt. Write minus outside. Minus sin t dt. What is integration of sin? Minus cos. Already one minus is there. Minus of minus plus. That is nothing but cos t plus c. Finally substitute t value. T value is nothing but cos x. So answer is cos of cos x plus c. Next. Fifth. Fifth question is important for 2 marks. Integral sin ax plus b into cos ax plus b. Okay, now in this question I am taking ax plus b equals to t. Differentiate with respect to x. A into x derivative 1 plus constant derivative 0 dx is equal to dt. Now you can write A dx is equal to dt. Send A this side. Dx is equal to 1 by A dt. Now substitute this value in the question. Question is changed to integral sin t cos t. In place of dx we can write 1 by a dt. For this expression 1 by a constant write outside divide with 2 multiply with 2 why because 2 sin theta cos theta formula is there in trigonometry 2 sin theta cos theta can be written as sin 2 theta okay now that is 1 by 2a into sin integration minus cos 2t by inner function derivative we are dividing inner function is 2t 2t derivative is 2 plus then minus 1 by 2 into 2a 4a into cos of 2 into t is nothing but ax plus b plus c that is the answer Next question, sixth, integral root ax plus b dx. So whenever root is given inside value, you can take t also correct or you can take t square also correct. Why square we are taking? If you take square, square and root both gets cancelled. That's why. If you take t, you will get answer. If you take t square also, you will get answer. Now I am taking let ax plus b equals to t square. I am taking. If you confuse with t square, you can take t also. That is also correct. Both you will get same answers. Why I took t square? If you take square, square and root gets cancelled. Okay. Now differentiate with respect to x. A into x derivative 1, constant derivative 0. Dx is equal to t square derivative 2t dt. Now from this you can write A dx is equal to 2t dt. Dx is equal to 2t by A into dt. Substitute this in this expression. Integral under root of, in place of ax plus b, I can write t square. Into in place of dx, I can write 2t by a. Here, square root gets cancelled. Two constant, a constant. I will write these two constant outside. T into t. T square. Now that equals to 2 by a into it is in the power of x power n plus 1 by n plus 1. That is nothing but t cube by 3 plus. So from this t can be written as root ax plus b is equal to t. Root means power 1 by 2 you will get. Now you will get 2 by 3a into t means ax plus b whole power 1 by 2 whole cube, that is nothing but whole power 3 by 2 plus c. Or otherwise, in place of t square, if you take t also, you will get the same answer. Next, seventh, evaluate integral x into under root of x plus 2 dx. Here also root is there. I am taking the value which is present in root is t square, or you can take t. Let x plus 2 is equal to t square. That implies I can write x is equal to t square minus 2. Okay. Now differentiate with respect to x. 1 plus 0. Dx is equal to t square derivative 2t dt. Now dx is equal to 2t dt. Substitute this value in the given question. Integral. In place of x, I can take t square minus 2 into under root of x plus 2 is nothing but t square. Dx is nothing but 2t dt. Here square and root gets cancelled. Now t square minus 2 into here t into 2t, I can write 2 outside. T into t, t square dt. Okay, now 2 into integral t square into t square t power 4 minus 2 constant, you write outside t square dt. So this is in the form of x power n plus 1 by n plus 1, that is nothing but 2 into t power 5 by 5 minus 2 into t cube by 3 plus c. But here we require t value. T square is equal to x plus 2. T what? Root x plus 2. Root means power 1 by 2. Substitute 2 by 5 x plus 2, 1 by 2 whole power 5, 5 by 2, 2 into 2 by 3, 4 by 3, t value x plus 2, 1 by 2 whole power 3, 3 by 2 plus c. Next, eighth question, homework, integral x into under root of 1 plus 2x square dx. Same method you try. The value which is present in the root, that is t. Next, ninth question. Integral 4x plus 2 into under root of x square plus x plus 1 dx. See, in this first you take 2 common in the bracket. If you take 2 common, what you will get? 2x plus 1 into under root of x square plus x plus 1 dx. So here I am taking, let x square plus x plus 1 is equal to t. Don't take this value t, no use. That is not suitable substitution. Differentiate with respect to x. X square derivative 2x plus x derivative 1 plus constant derivative 0 dx is equal to dt. This value is already present in the question. Now it should be simplified. 2 into integral root of this value t, 2x plus 1 dx is nothing but dt. Now root can be written as power 1 by 2. This is in the form of x power n, x power n plus 1 by n plus 1. That is nothing but 2 into t power 3 by 2 by 3 by 2 plus c. This 3 by 2 go to numerator, becomes 2 by 3, 2 into 2 by 3, 4 by 3. In place of t, we can substitute x square plus x plus 1 whole power 3 by 2 plus c.